Today's Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network telecast is made possible by Lincoln Electric System. It's your electricity, own it. Union Bank, you belong here. And Nebraska Wesleyan University.
We are going to overtime. For the first time in two seasons, Nebraska Wesleyan will be playing in overtime. We're tied at 31 between the Prairie Wolves and the Concordia Bulldogs. Jeff Motes, Lucas Mormon, Corey Ross, our Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network crew with you from Able Stadium in Lincoln. It is homecoming weekend for Nebraska Wesleyan, along with Hall of Fame weekend. So the folks that came back for homecoming or are here for the Hall of Fame have been treated to an interesting ball game this afternoon.
Well, yeah, it's been a dandy, and it's been a roller coaster ride. You know, solid first half. You give up the touchdown right before the break. You go in leading by three and tack on some points. And then Concordia comes storming back. But, man, the last 3 minutes of the fourth quarter really just owned by Nebraska Wesleyan. And that defense, I mean, they came up big. And they forced that punt for the Bulldogs. Fourth and one. Without that, it would have been game over.
We got some fireworks here.
Never a dull moment.
That's coming from the south parking lot.
And a house that we thought was almost on fire. Yeah. We got fireworks over to the right.
Yeah, we thought there was a house burning down across the street.
I mean, really, in just a great contest on the football field. I mean.
What else could liven the mood here?
Yeah.
Corey Ross, let's check in with you. Let's check in and see how things are coming along on the Nebraska Wesleyan sideline.
Hey, yes, this team is excited. Big kick with special teams. We talked about it a little earlier on how tough that was this entire season. Today, the protection has been very, very good. Big kick by Kramer Rath. Right now on the sidelines, guys are very, very focused, laser-sharp focused. Defense is talking about how to stop this read option and what's been helping and allowing Concordia to put some points up this second half. So they're focused right now offensively. They just want to stick to what's been working, and it's getting some short passes and getting and also might go back to running the ball right now out of that spread formation because it opens up the defense and opens up some lanes for them to get some. That's why they've been running the ball so well. So this is an exciting off overtime we're getting. And I said it earlier, it was going to be an exciting game. So right now, overtime. Let's see what happens.
All right, Corey, thanks a lot. And yes, you did say it was going to be an exciting game, no doubt, because obviously, the momentum shift has gone both ways today.
Won the toss, is elected to go on defense first. First and 10 of the 25.
So Wesleyan will play defense first. Concordia will have it at the 25-yard line. And remember, with overtime, if Concordia does not score on this particular series and Wesleyan gets the ball, then they score, then it's over with.
Right. All you need is a field goal, yeah.
Or
it's not the NFL type rules where,
right,
you know, you get a field goal only and the other team gets. This is take it at the 20 or the 30 25 yard line and let's get after it.
And really, you know, if Concordia can't convert, they try to go for a field goal and go up, then they, you know, have that three-point
right,
lead.
You have your option. You know what you have to do, which is why they picked to go on defense first. You want to know what your offense has to accomplish after their first possession here.
Handoff. Nope. A fake by Thomas. Thomas going to be taken down by Max Lawrence.
Well, see, now Thomas has been keeping a little bit more lately, and that time it looked like if he would have let Collins take that one, maybe he would have had a little running room. So 6-1, half dozen the other. Thomas was doing the damage in the fourth quarter. Let's see if they get back to pounding it with Bryce Collins a little bit here.
Second and 8. Now that pistol formation. And it's another zone read keep. by Thomas. Takes it inside the 20 to the Wesleyan 18.
And this overtime type situation is kind of
tripped up again.
It lends itself to the Concordia running attack. And you just need to keep the chains moving, but really Concordia's been the one stalling out in the red zone this afternoon. So this is where they usually get to their drive, and then, you know, early in the game, a couple times they've stalled down here, had some costly penalties. So big plays here, each one is magnified.
Third and three. Collins bumps off a tackle, and Betcher finally takes him down hard. And it was Phil Latimer who initially put the hit on Collins, and then Collins just got rattled.
He's hornswoggled by number 10.
After the initial hit at first, you're like, oh, I think he's going to squirt free. But right here, he tries to spin out of it. Again, a good solid tackle, wrapping up, driving the legs through, brings out the field goal unit.
So now Myros will attempt the field goal. They're going to mark it from about the 26. A 36-yard attempt down the middle. The snap and the hold. The kick is up. It's got distance. Does it go through? Yes, it does. So Concordia goes up 34-31.
Myros' kick is good.
And now Nebraska Wesleyan has got a turn here, and they know what they need to do on offense, like you said, Lucas.
At the very least, you got to get Garrett or Rath another try. If to win it, you get your touchdown. You know what you got to do.
So now Zumpf and Earhart, they're going to line up as the two receivers on the right side. Weedle in the backfield with Francis the quarterback. Jones is another split on the far side with Davis. As Wesleyan will get a crack. Down 34-31. Weedle takes the carry, and it's a loss of a yard on the play.
Just so many options with Zumpf. I mean, we've seen him make so many big plays over the last season and a half that it just feels like he's going to make a play here at some point, whether it's a big first down or a touchdown. I'm sure that's how teams that face him feel, too. Then it's going to happen, and it seems like it happens no matter what kind of coverage you put on him.
Weedle goes
back out of the backfield.
Catch made by Weedle at the 20. Still on his feet. Going to be tackled around the 17-yard line.
Big third down coming up here.
Joel Weedle. Tackle on the play by
Tate. They're going to mark him at the 18.
So a third and three. A long three. See if they keep it on the ground here. If they try and maybe one of those screen plays again, wouldn't be surprised.
Francis out of the gun. Looking to throw. Weedle open. Catch made at the 15. 10, 5, touchdown! Nebraska Wesleyan wins it! On an 18-yard toss, Joel Weedle!
And he was all alone.
He was wide open, nobody anywhere close to him. Unbelievable. And the hero of the day is Joel Weedle, the former Fremont Bergen Knight.
And he had 10 catches, 104 yards, but none more important than this one. There's nobody accounting for Weedle.
Nowhere. Not even in the neighborhood. And Joel Weedle wins it for Nebraska Wesleyan this afternoon on homecoming.
Well, Corey Ross said it's going to be an exciting second half.
And he wasn't kidding.
No joke.
And Corey's pumping his fist. Let's go down to Corey on the field right now.
Yo, I didn't know what to do. I think I dropped my mic. I turned into a Wesleyan fan over here. I got excited. Just what a great play. I think we've been watching it all day long. They caught him in a blitz and caught a play he calls macho, where the running backs leaks out into the flat, wide open, and all he had to do was run. Great call, great win, great first win, great home game win today for Nebraska Wesleyan.
Unreal. Corey Ross, thank you very much. And we may try to get some comments from Coach Keller here if possible, but there you see Weedle's play for the touchdown. And what an exciting
finish.
And
then he just waits for the dog pile because everyone's coming. 399 yards again passing this game for Tyler Francis. He was 33 completions-wise. Again, I mean, just crazy numbers. 399 yards through the air for Francis.
Unreal.
What another game. 31 of 49. And we saw some offense put up today, both sides. I mean, what a game here in Lincoln on this homecoming.
What an emotional win, too. I mean, you talk about
– Well, they're trying to not go 1-5. I mean, the last time they had that bad of a start was way back in 1996. You know, so that was something they didn't want to do.
Which was Coach Keller's first year.
That's right. So, I mean, this is – like I say, this is uncharted territory minus that first year.
We'll take a break and come back and try to get some final comments with Coach Keller in just a moment on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network.
You should pick Wesleyan because
it's a school that whatever you want to be in life, you can certainly do it.
I wanted a small school, small campus where I could be one-on-one with my professors.
It's just like one big family. Not to mention the kind of education she gets is wonderful.
I didn't apply to any of the schools. I know Wesleyan was the one that I wanted to come to.
We want you to come join us and be a part of the Prairie Wolf family and be a part of the tradition of success.
Oh, hi there. Sorry, couldn't see you at first. I'm Ryan with LES's Save Money, Saving Energy, and it's First Filter Friday, so I'm just checking my furnace filter here. Looks like it's about time for a clean one, which I just happen to have right here. You know, a small investment today can really reduce your heating costs and improve your efficiency. You can really see the savings. Yeah? For more tips like this, visit us at les.com or do a search for LES Video Vault on YouTube. We will see you next time.
I always paid attention to fashion when I was growing up. And it's just fun to see it go from sketch pad all the way to actually being on shelves. Shulda is a scarf with a pocket that you can store all of your basic necessities in. I think it's pretty amazing how quickly the company's grown. Union Bank has believed in me from day one. They have moved mountains for me to bring my product to life. The opportunity with Shulda has led me all over the country. I love what I do.
Hey, with Coach Keller here. Coach, when you woke up this morning, did you have the feeling you was going to win it in overtime today?
I don't know about overtime. The thing I was worried about, I'm thinking, you know, Corey's really been a bad luck charm for us this year. But, no, absolutely. But, you know, it's a really good week of practice. And something about Wesleyan and Concordia, that old rivalry, and playing them here, we don't lose here against Concordia, and we don't lose here on homecoming. So it's a great job, great effort by our kids to just show that resilience.
I like to stand in there near you sometimes during the game and kind of hear some of your plays. Take us through that last play. I heard macho. I've heard it a couple times today. Yep. Did that have anything to do with the running back coming out of the backfield?
Nope, like that? That's a blocking scheme. Okay. That's just a blocking scheme up front. But it's one of our favorite plays, our search route, and run a lot of different ways. And we thought they'd bring pressure and leave somebody wide open, and sure enough.
Hey, congratulations.
Right,
great victory. And hey, I'm not bad luck anymore.
All right, thanks.
There you go, Coach Keller. Great win today for Nebraska Wesleyan, and I am officially a fan. Back to you, fellas.
Oh, Corey, thank you so much. And, you've become a good luck charm now for Coach Keller in situations like this. But nonetheless, an exciting finish here at Able Stadium on homecoming this afternoon. The final score in overtime, Nebraska Wesleyan 37, Concordia 34. For Corey Ross, for Lucas Moran, our entire Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network crew, I'm Jeff Motes. Thanks along. Thanks for watching. Good afternoon from Able Stadium in Lincoln.
Today's Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network telecast was made possible by Lincoln Electric System. It's your electricity. Own it. Union Bank. You belong here. And Nebraska Wesleyan University.